Welcome back to another episode of the channel. So before I get into the video, I do appreciate the support, the feedback that I've been getting from everyone. It has been positive and it has been a bit of a motivation as well. I'm trying to put out as many videos as I can, but seeing that it's not the case where I work from home, I have to go out in the area to actually do my work. So I'm trying my best though. And also, don't forget to like, share, subscribe as well. If you're enjoying the content, or you can do so to help with someone in need. So in this video, I'll be talking about in the field, like what happens when you go on patrol and how it's set up and things like that. Alright, so when it comes on to patrol, alright, based on the numbers, because I was at 1GR at the time, so we had two sectors. So also I'm just trying to simplify this as best as possible. So we had two sectors. We have sector one and sector two. Both sectors comprise almost 100 troops. So I think close to 100 troops, yes. So in that sector, we were divided into squads. So in regards to squads, you have 1x4, 1x3, sometimes you have 1x5. What I mean by that is you would have one squad leader, or let's say NCOs, and the rest would be normal soldiers. It could be either a lance corporal, a corporal, or just a senior man, as I said. Would be squad leader or NCO. And the rest would be like typical soldiering. So you would have, one of the duties that they would have a set town for certain location. Because you know, already placed in a group for certain locations already, so you muster. And at least if you didn't call the name and tell say, you and this, you work with this man, and you and them go. Call this, you and them go all time. Is it? And them would actually make you know, especially because you have morning, would I leave you them for last night, and you have evening shift, would I say about till morning. So you don't have a set of people, I think they don't have at least four scheduled for the foot, and around 3 to 4 would drive around on the ratty van. So you have the people where you drive around on the ratty in an area there, and you don't have the foot patrol, one of them that walk around the foot. But as them say, they could actually, if they're on the point or they're on the checkpoint, and in time the SOE and Zozo did go on in time down them side. So yeah, you could have, when you're at checkpoint, you could have still the foot patrol, can him say we're not supposed to just turn up at a checkpoint that just did it, so you can do 1-2 foot patrol, is it? So it's like a relieving system, so you relieve another party for another party, you know. So when you get sort out and everything, then make sure, say if you have a weapon from before, you gotta go collect your weapon. Mostly who go get to collect their weapon are woman them, because woman them have left them weapon because where them go? Now they in 1GR headquarters. So they have to left them weapon and then collect back them weapon. And then everybody gets sought out and the driver them would have come for they chuck them and you just have to wait. And then boom. Then they just hop on the truck, just head out, just have to just wait till they reach a specific destination and all them things there. And then they relieve you. But overall, that's patrolling. But you see, if you're up on the checkpoint, basically, you're just practically just stop vehicles, check vehicles, all of that. That's and document it. Because although you would go there and see why 1 and 2 police on the point, you know, because police them get relieved too. Sometimes you'd say 1, sometimes you'd say 2, and after the most. But most of the point them are the most soldier there. So in regards to the checkpoint, there's not much you do, and then I stop vehicle and everything. But foot them now, when them walk on foot, them now, foot patrol basically walk with the police. So them when I just go through like the various communities like Scott Road, that I feel like that's a sector 2. I see them thing apply to sector 1 too, but them in a like different area, like you know, go like the, you know, more rural area, them like city area, them where you know more rich people are there. Like in a ear like them day. But yeah, in regards to the foot patrol, them when I just walk around and watch with community them and stop off and stop and anybody who looks suspicious and check them and them thing there. That's mostly where foot patrol and sometimes they pass through the various checkpoint them. And we just probably just hold a 1 or 2 conversation and make you know what go on around this and all them thing there. And the one them drive narrative and them drive through the place. Look if nobody look too suspicious and tap. If they get no orders, we go check out nothing, go and go check it out and them thing there. Cause I remember one incident when we did actually the road and one woman had some domestic dispute because she has said she can't handle this up. I don't even, I think the place name Hollywood, yeah, the place name Hollywood, somewhere in the St. John's side. So she did have a domestic dispute with some people around here, because they were trying to kill her and them thing there, because the people over there, like them are thief people, carrying her thief people things and them thing there. So she did have to come over here and a ball and a beg, we say, yo, them over there, she's going to kill her, and she have her picnic, and she don't want to deal with her picnic, so she have to go live. And as much as we are trying to understand what she has, and I say, Miss, calm down, we are trying to best help. Woman just like get mad. When Squaddy and two of my friends walk over there, me and say, oh, she should go, she left. And I say, oh, damn, brother, could have a little thing that right there, so for you, know, but nothing really happened. So, in short, basically, you might go up on the road, you might buck up in some things, you watch your place and see man start lift up. But in my mind, when me there do it, me never really get no much action on them things. Because anytime people see soldier watch you and them, where people lift up, so people never really stay. So basically, patrolling is not that much. Or you just patrol until when your shift about in, until when them come relieve your back. So that's basically what patrolling is. So you don't have to really go get figure up on the right even or get figure up on foot, because most of them go actually just end up on checkpoint due to the SOE and the zone of special operation. So rather than that, if them call if you do know for my security, like if you go standpoint somewhere or anything like that. But me mostly what I did was actually just typical SOE shit. Just go up on checkpoint, walk place, search people, search vehicle, top vehicle, build up traffic, all them things. That was what we did, or what me did go through at that time. I really got through nothing major. All on for New Year's, when man them, you know, PM and I go bust up, be a shot and them things. They them bust up shot round corner, but we personally can't move. Oh yes, and we even forget to send them that. You see, if you end up on a checkpoint and any shooting going on there, unless you know how to left it, or you're not supposed to left. Unless the police are going there, then you can go down there the police. But other than that, you're not supposed to get up off your checkpoint and see man I get shot down the road and go down there. Mm-mm. You have to just stay put and just watch. It kind of sound messed up, but it is what it is. And if you go down there, go do it, you're in a problem right there. So you just have to just, if squaddy not go down there, you can't go down there. If squaddy have to at least go down there for you, go down there behind him, because that give him support. Because certain things that right there, so wouldn't be for your jurisdiction. Because remember, soldier can't lock up people and them things. The most them can do, like if them hold on somebody have to kill them gas station, they can't just restrain them and kill them gas station. You get me? But overall, I hope this video was informative and I hope that you learned something as well, even though it was not much. But you guys should understand the drip. So just to sum it up, basically, you have 2 sectors, sector 1 and 2. You get placed in a different squad, you tell you exactly where you go and which duties you're supposed to uphold. You jump out and head out and go relieve other man them, and then them will come to camp, and then the next day them will relieve it. And then that's how the process keep on repeat until them change shift. So thank you for making it to the end of the video. So like, subscribe, and don't forget to share the video with someone that you might think it will be informative to. So, Unknown is out.